Hello friends, today we are going to start our module E and that includes digital banking. So digital banking is the move to online banking where banking services are delivered over the internet. That means in this digital banking, most of the work are being transferred through the internet. What is the advantage for the banks and customers? So, advantage for the banks and customers are providing more convenient and faster banking services. It involves high level of process automation and web-based services and may include API enabling cross-institutional service composition to deliver banking product and provide transactions. And it also provides the ability for the user to access financial data through desktop, mobile, and ATM services. But for the digital services, there has to be some information security. So here are the three components of the information security that is called CIA. CIA means, C means confidentiality, integrity, and availability. So what is meaning of confidentiality? Confidentiality means the data should be confidential. It's not be open to the public. It should be made available to the person who is dealing or who is authorized to see the information. That is called confidentiality. And what is meaning of integrity? Integrity means any change carried out in the data that must be recorded, must be recorded, and it must be available for the future audit. Okay, and what is meaning of availability? So availability means data, when data is asked or when data is retrieved, that must be available at that particular time and at that particular place. That is called availability. So I just repeat here, main components of information security are CIA. C stand for confidentiality, and I stand for integrity, and A stand for availability. And there is also one scheme was launched by RBI that is called Ombudsman Scheme for Digital Transaction. Before that, there was common Ombudsman Scheme was there that was with the initiative by RBI. Now, RBI has started because the role of digital transaction is increasing. So, for digital transaction, one separate Ombudsman Scheme has been initiated, that is with effect from 31st January 2019. And Deputy Governor General is the Ombudsman. Okay, maybe Deputy or Deputy Governor General or Assistant, not Governor, Governor General, it is Governor, Deputy Governor or Assistant, maybe the Ombudsman. So I'll repeat here, who is Ombudsman? So Ombudsman is Deputy Governor General or its equivalent, maybe Assistant Governor also. Okay. Now, what are the types of digital banking payment? So, here are the list here. So, I will discuss all. Like banking card is there, unstructured supplementary services is called USSD. And next is called Aadhaar Enabled Payment System, AEPS. And then next is UPI is there, mobile wallet is there, and next POS terminal is there, and internet and mobile banking is there. So we just see one by one in the brief. So mobile cards are not only used to withdraw cash but also enable other form of digital payments. Cards can be used for online transaction and on point of sale machines. Prepaid cards can also be issued by the bank. Such cards are not linked to the bank account but function through the money loaded onto them. Now next, we'll discuss banking cards separately because many types of cards are there. So we'll discuss the types of cards also. Unstructured supplementary service data. This full form you have to remember, USSD. Unstructured supplementary service data. By dialing the number *99#, mobile transaction can be carried out without an application and internet connection. So this initiative has been launched. It is very popular in villages where the mobile connectivity and applications are not there. Here people are using not that upgraded mobile or very costly mobile, so they can use this transaction, means *99#. And the number holds nationwide applicability and promote greater financial inclusion on the ground level. The service lets the caller surf through an interactive voice menu and choose the desired option on the mobile screen. Okay, so this scheme is very popular, means it is applicable on the ground level where the internet connectivity is not there and people are not having very costly mobile, where the applications cannot be downloaded. But there is only one catch in this system, USSD. Mobile number of the caller should be one linked to the particular bank account. This is the means mobile number of the caller should be one linked to the particular bank account. That means mobile number must be linked, same number must be linked to the bank account. Okay. Now next, Aadhaar enabled payment system. This system is also very popular in villages and rural areas. Okay. So AEPS let the clients initiate banking instructions following the successful verification of the Aadhaar number. Okay. So this is also very popular. Now, this unified payment interface, this is now becoming very, very popular in cities. Okay. So UPI is most trending form of digital banking presently. UPI makes use of virtual payment address, VPA. Okay, that is also called UPI address. So the user can transfer fund without entering bank account details or IFSC code. So UPI application also let you consolidate all your bank account into one place. Okay, so that means in the same UPI application, you can link many accounts in one place. Funds can be transferred and received around the clock with no time restriction. That means this is working 24 hours basis. UPI based application in India are, so who are the players? Number one is the Bheem, Bharat Interface for Money. This is launched by Government of India. PhonePe, these are the private players, and Google Pay, and many more are coming, like Amazon Pay and Samsung Pay, many more are coming. And Bheem application, in addition to transfer of funds to the other virtual address and bank account, also let the user transfer fund to another Aadhaar number. Okay, so Bheem has many other applications also. More importantly, UPI based payments are free of cost. That's why this method is becoming nowadays popular. Now, what is the mobile wallets? So, mobile wallets have eliminated the needs to remember 4-digit card pins. That means you don't require to remember the 4-digit pin or enter CVV details or carry loose cash. So, mobile wallets store bank account and card credential to easily add fund to the wallet and make payment to the other merchant with the similar application. Okay, so there are difference between UPI based payment and mobile wallet. In UPI based, the bank account number is directly linked with the application and transfer amount is from or in from the account number to account number. Whereas in mobile wallet, the money is transferred, first transferred means just like a wallet, it is created and money is kept separate out of the bank account number. That means while using the mobile wallet, you not required to enter the bank account number. Okay. Popular mobile wallets are like Paytm, FreeCharge. Now Paytm has become also UPI application. Earlier it was a mobile wallet. Now it has changed to the UPI application. FreeCharge is there, MobiKwik is there. So mobile wallets, however, generally have a limit on how much can be deposited in the wallet. A small fee may be also charged on depositing the fund from mobile wallet back to the bank account. That means if you withdraw the money from the mobile wallet, they may charge some fees also. Okay. Now, moving ahead, the POS terminal. So, typically, POS machines are portable devices that read a card to authorize and complete the payment. supermarkets and gas stations opt for this method for payment. However, with the digital banking thriving, the POS terminal have evolved into more than physical POS devices. Virtual and mobile POS terminal have surfaced, which makes use of mobile phones, NFC features and web-based application to initiate the payment. That means NFC means without touching the your credit card, debit card in the POS machine, you can make the payment. Okay. Now, internet and mobile banking, commonly known as e-banking. And nowadays we refer also to e-banking. Internet banking refers to obtaining certain banking services over the internet, such as fund transfer, opening, closing accounts. Internet banking is a subset of digital banking. Okay. So, because internet banking is involving, you can do anything, whatever you expect from the bank branch, you can do anything in your house without going to the bank. Okay. So, internet banking is a subset of digital banking because internet is only limited to core functions. Similarly, mobile banking is available. Availing banking services through mobile-based application. So, that means internet banking and mobile banking both are same. Only difference is there. Here you are using the mobile and sometimes you may be using the mobile app also for the banking. Okay. Now, so now we'll discuss cards in details. So, cards can be classified on the basis of their issuance, usage and payment by the cardholder. So, types of cards includes debit card, credit card, ATM card, prepaid card, store value card, and charge card. So, benefits of card payment to customer include convenience, flexibility, and control and security. So, these are the benefits. That's why the ATM, debit card, and credit cards are become popular nowadays. So, now we'll discuss what are the cards. These types of card. Magnetic strip card, mega strip cards are those in which data is stored in a magnetic band. You might have seen some ATM cards which are having one black strip. And chip cards are those where the data is stored in a microprocessor chip embedded in the card. Okay. Nowadays, this magnetic strip is being replaced by the chip, or some of the cards having both. Okay. While all EMV cards are chip cards, because all chip cards are not EMV cards. So, this is very, very important points here. That means, what the main features has been added here, that means EMV cards. Now, are chip cards, but all chip cards are not EMV cards. Keep in mind, EMV is a communication exchange protocol between the cards and the POS terminal. Okay. The communication can happen electronically if chip is inside the card reader of the POS. Okay. If the exchange is wireless via NFC, we'll discuss NFC later on because the card and the POS. Okay. So, how to communicate between the POS and the card? So, it may be with the touching of the cards also and can be without. Now, sometimes you might have seen nowadays, now just you bring your card near to the POS, your transaction will happen. Okay. So, EMV transaction allows online as also online authentication contact and also contactless transaction, means online authentication and contact as a also contactless transaction. So there are mainly three types of cards are there. Mainly I'm discussing here debit card, credit card, prepaid cards. Okay. So debit cards means the card which can be used to withdraw cash up to the limit present in the customer's bank account. Okay. These cards are also known as bank card, plastic card, check cards. Keep in mind, sometimes this question can be asked, which of the following is known as bank card, also plastic card, check card. So, to get issued debit card, one should have bank account because your debit card is directly linked with your bank account. So, minimum requirement is that a person must have a bank account. This means the debit card are only issued by bank which are linked to the customer's bank account number. So, in the case to use debit card, one should have enough balance in this bank account because your debit card is directly linked with the bank account. So, money will be withdrawn or money will be spent directly from your bank account. They are used to withdraw cash from ATM, purchase of goods, services at point of sale or you can do the e-commerce also. That means you can purchase online also, both domestically and internationally. Okay. Now, we'll discuss what are the parts of debit card and credit card. So, we first go through what are the debit cards. Okay. So, bank branding. Because the features of bank and debit card both are same. That means designing is same. So, we'll discuss together. And except, what is difference between debit and credit card? In debit card, the money is transferred immediately. Money is spent immediately. And with credit card, money is spent on the later. Okay. So, bank branding. Number one feature is bank branding. That means this section identifies your card issuer. Okay, that means your bank logo will be there on the front side of the card. Okay, card number, it is a number that identifies your account with the card issuer. And those are digits you need to provide then making purchase online or by phone. Okay, so it is typically 16 digits. Though some manufacturer use the as it is 14 or 19 digits. So, you can just see here. Typically, it is 16 digits, but it may be 14 digits also, sometimes 19 digits also. And if it is personalized debit card or credit card, your name will also be printed on that. If it is not personalized, so name may be missing from the front side of card. Okay. And expiration date is always mentioned. Okay. That means month and year will be mentioned. And what is the back side of card? So, if it is magnetic strip is there, so you can see the magnetic strip is there. Black strip contains information about you and your card and a specialized device known as card reader gather that information. Every time you swipe your card at the merchant, you run the magnetic strip through a card reader to provide your payment details. Nowadays, magnetic strip's card has been replaced with the chip card. So, nowadays, these are out of phase. Okay. Hologram is there. Some cards display a hologram or mirror-like area showing a three-dimensional image that seems to move as you change your view angle. So, hologram are security features which help merchant identify valid cards. Okay. And holograms are hard to fake. That means it is difficult to make a duplicate hologram. Sometimes hologram appear on the front side of card also. Okay. And in the backside card also, you get the bank contact information also. Yeah, because in case of a difficulty, you may contact the bank on 24 hours basis. Okay. And one place you'll find one white space or blank space is there where signature of the card holders are required. Okay. And one three-digit security code is also there. CVV. So, cards are printed with the original code to have the ensure that somebody using the card number has a legitimate original card. Okay. And sometimes network logo is also there. You might have seen network logos on the back of and lower right corner. See, this logo help you to figure out which ATM can you use for free. Okay. Next come credit card. So, unlike debit card, in case of credit card, customer can also withdraw beyond the amount of money present in his bank account. Okay. But there is a limit for cash, each credit card up to which extra money can be withdrawn. That means even if amount is not there in your bank account, you can withdraw the amount. That means on credit. That's why it is called credit card. Okay. And also there is time limit up to which extra money withdrawn should be paid back. This amount of money is paid back along with the interest charge as applied by the issuer of the card. They are issued by bank and other entities put by RBI. Okay. So, credit cards are used for purchase of goods and services at the point of sale and e-commerce online purchase through interactive voice responses like IVR, recurring transaction, mail order telephone order moto. So, these are the applications of credit card. Okay. These cards can be used domestically and internationally. The credit cards can be used to withdraw cash from an ATM and transferring fund to bank account. Okay, now next going ahead, prepaid cards. So, usage of prepaid cards depends on who has issued these cards. They can be issued by bank or non-bank institutions both. To get issue a prepaid card, the customer has to pay the amount in advance, which is then stored in his prepaid cards to be used whenever required. It's just like you know charging your mobile. Right? You charge for like prepaid cards. Right? Your prepaid mobile is there. So you first pay, then you use it. So same fashion. You can recharge your card, then you can use it. So, a prepaid card is never linked to a bank account because not required, you are paying and you are using. So, linking to account is not required. Maximum value that can be stored in a prepaid card at any point of time is 1 lakh rupees. The prepaid card issued by bank can be used to withdraw cash from an ATM, purchase of goods and services at the point of sale, or e-commerce online purchase can also be done. They can be used domestically, okay, and fund transfer can also be done from person to person. Okay, such prepaid cards are known as open system prepaid cards. That means the prepaid cards which are used for transfer fund from one person to another are called open system prepaid card. Okay. However, the prepaid card issued by authorized non-bank entities can be used only for purchase of goods and services at point of sale or e-commerce online and for the domestic transfer from one person to another. So, what is difference between open card and semi-closed system prepaid cards? So, we'll see here. So, main difference is that open cards are issued by bank, prepaid card issued by bank. And so, feature is same, only difference is that open cards are issued by bank, whereas the semi-closed issued by non-bank entities. Okay, so this is the difference between open prepaid cards and semi-closed prepaid cards. And there is also closed prepaid cards. So closed prepaid cards are those cards which are limited to particular establishment roles only. You might have seen this some petrol companies, HP, and these are issuing the cards. You can just purchase the petrol from that companies only. So they are limited to that establishment role. So other type of cards are known as smart card. So it contains an electronic chip that is used to store cash. There is no requirement of any signature, identification, and payment authorization. The exact amount is deducted from the smart card during the payment and collected by the smart card reader machine. So it's very simple type of card is there, smart card. And some co-branded cards are also there. A credit card that is offered by the credit card company that is jointly sponsored by bank and the retail merchant. These cards generally covered with a variety of incentives such as discount and rebates. Nowadays, this has become popular because some of the companies in jointly with the bank, they are issuing the co-branded cards. Okay. Now, NPCI in our India. Now, we are talking about the NPCI, means National Payment Corporation of India, has its own Indian version of debit card and credit card. So it is similar to international cards such as Master and Visa. Earlier Master and Visa cards were popular. Nowadays it has been replaced. That means Indian version of debit card, credit card is the RuPay card. Okay. So it is launched by NPCI and all major public sector banks have started using the RuPay card. So what are the benefits? Why we should use the RuPay card? So, transaction cost is reduced with the help of RuPay card because we are using domestically. Okay. User get alert for every transaction made through these cards. The processing fees of RuPay card is considerably low as compared to other credit card and debit card. So, this is the benefits of you having RuPay card. And now RuPay card is also offering the insurance up to some amount. These keep on changing, so you have to see the what are the current status of the insurance. Kisan credit cards is a scheme to provide timely and credit to farmer to meet their production credit needs besides meeting contingency expenses and expenses related to ancillary activity through a simplified procedure. So Kisan credit card offering credit to farmer of two types. Number one is cash credit and number one is called the term credit. So this is the scheme is very popular in villages where the farmers, they require a contingent fund, you know, during their agriculture process. Okay. Now NFC near field communication, this technology is coming nowadays. So NFC is a system of contactless communication that enables data sharing between devices like smartphone and tablets, laptops. So what is full form of NFC? Near field communication. With NFC, an user can gesture their phone towards an enabled device and share information without manually establishing a connection. So with its speed and convenience, the technology has become in the mainstream. Okay, how it works, we'll see here, because it is a new technology, so we have to see how it works. It is easy to assume that NFC operation is an extension of Wi-Fi or Bluetooth technology. That means this operation is same as Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, but all these three systems support wireless communication and data transfer. And NFC operate using electromagnetic field, whereas Wi-Fi and Bluetooth use radio transmission. So this is the main difference between Wi-Fi, Bluetooth and NFC. So NFC is using electromagnetic fields. Okay, whereas Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, they use the radio frequency transmission. So NFC extends from radio frequency identification technology. RFID is often used for inventory and material management, attendance tracking, as well as security access control, while basic principle of this technology are incredibly similar, where NFC is using which technology? Electromagnetic field. But this operation is limited to close proximity radius. Okay. So means radius of like somewhere it is 10 centimeter. Okay, that means when your card is read by one POS, so it's be within 10 centimeter only. That means you have to bring your card near to that POS machine. So most users consider NFC proximity control to be significant security assets given the considerable role it play in mobile payment. So people are worried about the NFC proximity because even if you are not purchasing, your data can be transferred to the NFC devices. So there are two types of NFC devices. Number one is active, number one is passive. So active devices means they immediately read the information, and passive devices means you have to switch on, then you can transfer your data. Okay. So it is more than a digital wallet. While mobile payment may be the easiest way to understand NFC, the technology can be applied to more than tap and go purchase. So you must remember this wording, tap and go. NFC device means technology also known as tap and go purchase. Means you bring your debit card, credit card near to POS and your purchasing is done. Okay. But there is also security concern. While there is number of NFC applications providing significant value to the user, for many, security remains a big point of concern. So consumer want to ensure that their data and money is safe. Similarly, merchant, they want their system and customers are protected. Bank want that their transactions and fund are secure. Okay. So now moving ahead, we'll see the new terminology that is called eavesdropping. It is when someone listen in, like when someone is listening, that means someone is stealthily listening your transactions. Okay, on the transaction. So via eavesdropping, information can be intercepted and obtained by a malicious party. Okay, however, very nature of NFC inherently limit the risk, since the device must be in close range, within 10 centimeter, maybe sometimes 4 centimeter, and sometimes 10 centimeter. Okay, to send the signal, it is much more difficult to intercept these signals because you have to bring your device very close proximity. And furthermore, there is additional feature that NFC is having. NFC chips device aren't always active. When your phone is locked and not in use, NFT, NFC device isn't actively sending any data. So this is the additional feature that NFC working. It doesn't become active until you want it to. For example, when you are checking out a store using a contactless terminal, this means on top of somebody being very close to you, they would have to be extremely lucky in order to intercept your signal. Okay. And regarding the data manipulation, this is when there is an attempt to manipulate or corrupt the NFC communication data. Data manipulation risk can be significantly reduced with the use of secure channel. And some device have the ability to listen or prevent data corruption attack. Now we'll see what is interception attack. So these are when an outsider party tries to take advantage of active passive mode of device to send and receive NFC transmission data. Okay. So when outside party tries to take advantage of active or passive mode of device, that means they want to intercept your data, that's called interception data. Okay. And what is relay attacks? There is concern over the possibility related. Theoretically, an attacker could leverage relay software and a card emulator. So relay attack is also a major concern, but it is difficult. In past also relay attack was done in Google Wallet, but the issue has been resolved. So an attacker could leverage relay software and a card emulator. So in fact, this was a proven that threat when researchers Michael Ronald, he was able to complete live payment transaction in Google. There was earlier version of Google Wallet, but now this issue has been resolved. Okay. Now there is one more threat is there that is called device theft. Your mobile is lost. Somebody has the big data for whatever intention to be there. So another concern that has surfaced is with the device theft. If someone has access to the device, any encryption is rendered is useless. Is what your device is gone. So in theory, a person is possession of the phone can use or make payment or purchase at any NFC enabled point of sale terminal that accept payment via mobile wallet. However, this threat can be mitigated using simple step on the part of device owner, such as ensuring this phone has an access passcode. That's why nowadays you must lock your phone. Even if that means phone is locked, you will not be able to open so easily. Additionally, ensuring that a lost phone isn't used for such purchase is as easy as cancelling the credit card or associated account. So it is essential when the phone is lost because your data may be stored in your mobile phone. So in such case, Android user can access Android device manager to remove all financial details. And Apple user can erase information with the Find My Phone features. Okay. Finally, many devices have another step of verification, such as fingerprint scan is there. Apple Pay have significantly limit the risk of anybody that device owner using the complete mobile payment. Okay, so many company they are having like now OTP concept is also coming here. That means you are the real owner, OTP will come. So many features are coming to play. So security measures, security concerns aren't exclusive to mobile payments, but also a number of other potential and realize NFC application. However, there has been a quite a lot done to ensure that mobile payments via NFC are safe for all interested parties, including merchant and customers. We will go over a number of these security measures, both inherent in the technology and created at a higher degree of protection. Okay. And proximity. Many proponent points out that by virtue of proximal nature of NFC, okay, device must be within 4 cm to communicate. Attackers are more difficult to execute as discussed above because you have to bring your device close proximity. So this is the problem of the attacker, because attacker cannot come so closer. So that may be problem for the other type of data transfer. While still possibility is there, while requirement of attacker to be very close to the device that are communicating with another in order to work. So proximity features is also giving the security measures to the NFC enabled devices. So with this we finish our part 1 of digital banking. We'll bring the part 2 also, and after that our digital banking will finish. So thank you very much for watching my video. You please share this video for other who are writing this exam CIB, so that they should be benefited by my effort. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.